The Caribbean Tourism Organization has been celebrating upon hearing the news that the UK government has announced a freeze on APD charges that were previously resulting in higher aviation taxes for travelers to the tropical islands. It is also hoped that with the lack of these taxes, British tourists will return to the region.
The government is now going to go internally. And it's our understanding that they'll be coming out with a response somewhere between September and October. All early indications would suggest that the tax will be changed. And instead of being four bands as it presently is, more than likely it's going to go to two bands. And there's a lot of speculation in terms of the quantum of the tax on those two bands. So that's what we're really waiting to hear in terms of being able to move forward.
St. Lucia has been enjoying a fair share of British holiday goers who make the Caribbean their destination year after year. Visitors to the Caribbean from the UK had to pay £75 per person in economy class, which was a huge deciding factor on their choice of holiday destination. Now that Britain has officially frozen the air passenger duty tax, local officials are suggesting that the levy be subject to further review.
There is a meeting with the United Kingdom in October, which will be held in Grenada. We're working on making a special part of that meeting to discuss tourism. But once we've heard the announcement in terms of whether there'll be any changes and what those changes are going to be, at that point we would then re-engage with the UK government. But obviously the region has reserved its right that, depending on what the outcome is, to still challenge this tax under the WTO, which is the World Trade Organization.
Minister Chastney says the British are expected to issue a response with regards to the changes in the APD tax between the months of September and October this year. Reporting for the DBS News World, I am Cecil Actil.